the exuberation for the challenger, Pedro Morales.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is the feature attraction. One fall to a finish. Introducing from Russia, 295 pounds, wrestling heavyweight champion, Ivan Koloff. Pounds, the U.S. American champion, Pedro Morales. Terry Terrano, the referee, one fall to a finish.
One fall to a finish. These matches at the time governed by the New York State Athletic Commission, many of their members sitting at ringside. And in those days, Madison Square Garden had a curfew for wrestling. The matches had to end by 11 p.m. This match going on earlier in the evening. One fall to a finish. The WWWF title on the line. And it's obvious to hear in the background that the native Puerto Rican Pedro Morales has brought many of his friends here tonight in the form of fans. For Morales' first major championship opportunity here at Madison Square Garden. Morales, a southpaw, always known for his thunderous left hands and the respect and the discomfort showed by the champion, Ivan Koloff, respecting and complaining about the attempted use of the fist by Pedro Morales. Koloff, very unusual for his era here as we take him back to February 8, 1971, where Koloff just 5 pounds shy of the magical 300-pound mark. And in the early 70s, that was a rarity, especially with the agility and the strength, the mat wrestling ability of a man like Koloff. A very tight collar and elbow tie-up. Neither man gaining the advantage. And again, you see Morales with that fiery Latin temper. Very ready to use his fists. And this certainly an indication of Koloff playing or attempting to play some mind games with the challenger Morales and try to take this huge pro-Morales crowd out of it. Plus, Koloff doesn't want to get hit simply with those rights and especially the left hand of Morales. Morales weighed in on this night at 246, giving up about 50 pounds to Koloff. And you hear the crowd in the background cheering with Morales gaining the advantage. They drop, and Morales showing his quickness with a succession of offense here. Very basic body slams and perfectly executed side headlock. Morales keeping his game plan, as many competitors did in this era, very ground oriented. Unless it was a wrestler's absolute specialty, very few wrestlers would lead their feet voluntarily in this era. Morales, notice the side lock from the left side. Morales being that southpaw, as we noted. Stronger arm of the two being his left, utilizing that in the headlock. Crowd reacting to Koloff's attempt, subterfuge, if you will, of pulling the hair of the challenger. Again, this was Koloff's first title defense here in the garden, as this crowd, as you can hear them getting behind every offensive move that Pedro Morales is able to successfully execute. Referee taking a good look to make sure that Koloff is not doing anything illegal. And Koloff now thinking thinking about pulling the tights for an unfair advantage. This official assigned by the New York State Athletic Commission. Certainly, I'm sure an experienced boxing and wrestling official. You notice the four rings, ring ropes used in this match. Very reminiscent, exactly like, as a matter of fact, a boxing ring. As Morales continues to utilize that left arm and that side headlock. And Koloff getting a little frustrated there. And Morales beats Koloff to the punch until a hard shot to the abdomen. And this was a turning point offensively for Ivan Koloff, the champion in this match. And Koloff now the much larger of the two men with the obvious advantage in upper body strength, utilizing a rear chin lock. Not only is the arm tight around the neck of Morales, but Morales having to carry a great deal of that near 300 pounds of Ivan Koloff in this particular position. Koloff known for his use of the bear hug. Is deadly. Referee detected a choke there. And certainly Morales can ill afford. Oh, a knee right to the face. And there you see the power. This very base wrestling style of the WWWF champion, Ivan Koloff. And again, Koloff turning that reverse chin lock into a chokehold, which is continuing to rob the very popular Puerto Rican sensation, Pedro Morales, of his oxygen. Morales trying to pull himself back up, and the fiery Morales again scores with that left hand. Watch the effective use of the left hand of Pedro Morales, and now with this sold-out, turned-away crowd, solidly behind Morales, cheering the challenger on. Again, the wily veteran Koloff looking to slow down the momentum of the challenger, maybe even take this crowd a little bit out of it. And the veteran Pedro Morales, too smart to fall for the disingenuous nature of the attempt of sportsmanship by Ivan Koloff, whose long-standing reputation as a rule breaker precedes him. Again, this match one fall to a finish. These men do have to deal with the curfew again, this match being over by 11 o'clock here in Madison Square Garden. Koloff with that strength, a move known as a Greco-Roman knuckle lock. And Koloff extremely powerful with his upper body, and is, quite frankly, he's just a powerhouse from head to toe. But Morales has that great will to win. The opportunity of a lifetime sets before Morales, and Morales scores with a monkey flip, much again to the delight of these thousands upon thousands who have sold out Madison Square Garden days in advance of this golden opportunity for a young man by the name of Pedro Morales, who has certainly earned this chance. For many fans here, they still have a hard time believing that it was 3 weeks ago that the legendary Bruno Sammartino's 7.5-year reign as WWWF champion ended at the hands of the Russian bear, Ivan Koloff. Koloff now again with that side headlock, a rake of the eyes, and the rake of the eyes has allowed a free passage to the execution of a bear hug by Ivan Koloff. And Morales smartly distracted the referee a left hand in that momentarily broke up this torturous bear hug, where the lower back and the kidney area is the focus of those massive arms of the champion. This match will not end without controversy. Again, we're taking it back February 8, 1971. They sold out Madison Square Garden. Ivan Koloff, the new WWF champion, meeting the then reigning U.S. American champion, Pedro Morales, title not on the line in this match. Morales had been waiting in the wings for what I'm sure to him seemed like an eternity, in the shadow of the great Bruno Sammartino. And Morales, with his great competitive spirit, countering the bear hug with a scoop body slam on the near 300-pounder. But much to Koloff's credit, his will to maintain the title is as strong as Morales' will to take it. But Morales coming back with a very basic scoop body slam, a rake of the eye, it looked like, and Koloff seeming to feel a little sense of desperation as these two competitors colliding in the ring, which of course is advantageous to the champion, Koloff, because Morales knows, his fans know, that Morales cannot win this title on a countout. Morales trying a slam again, his back gave way, and the oohs and ahs of this crowd as the Russian bear tried a big splash. The quickness of Morales certainly coming into play here, as the crowd, as you can see, they're standing, they're cheering, they're willing Pedro Morales back into this match. Koloff, the Russian bear, begins to and has regained a vertical base. Koloff again using his strength, and now Koloff quickly goes outside. Big turning point in this match. Koloff looking for the knee drop off the top. His most deadly finishing maneuver, but Morales able to avoid that contact and certain defeat. And now Morales will take his first major chance of this championship match. And Morales with a cross body could not hold the champion, Koloff. Many of the fans here thought it was going to be over there. Fans standing, New York City's finest surrounding the ring. Short Irish whip by Koloff, the champion, looking to put Morales away. Morales from one corner to the other, three turnbuckles, Morales in trouble. And Morales using his legs to push back, and the shoulder comes up. The referee's count. Koloff's shoulders were down. Morales' shoulder came up. And listen to this crowd. Look at this crowd. It is jubilation. It is bedlam. It is pandemonium. And there the former champion, the great Bruno Sammartino, in the ring to congratulate the new champion.